Everybody, in this video we are going to share how the Boss GT1000 looper works and how to set a patch or preset with some effects and the looper controllers. Before starting, let me tell you that in my YouTube channel you can find two other videos about the GT1000. One is a demo and review of the unit, and the other one is about how to create your own effect chain that is useful to follow even to understand better this video that we are going to share. Now let's go back to the looper. First of all, let me clarify that the recording time of the GT1000 is limited to up to 38 seconds in mono and 19 seconds in stereo, and that the preset patches from P51 to P55 and U51 to U55 are already set to command the looper functions with the three upper control switches. Nevertheless, in this video I'm going to show you how to build your own patch with the looper functions assigned to three of the five bottom switches and with the rest of the pedal switches assigned to effect. With the rest of the switches you can switch on and off effect. Basically, the effect chain I want to build as a univibe, a compressor, then the signal is split in two. In the first way we have the clean sound, in the other way we have the distorted sound. In the clean sound I'm using a Vox amp simulation, while in the distorted sound I'm using a so-called XI gain, that is a Boss proprietary amp. Then after the amp I have the tremolo, a delay, a chorus, a reverb, and then finally the looper functions. Now the looper has five basic functions that are record, play, overdub, stop, and clear. In order to use the loop you must assign these functions to the desired pedal switches. In the GT1000 these five functions can be assigned to three switches, assigning the record, play, and overdub functions to one switch, the stop function to another switch, and the clear function to another switch again. And I will try to explain how to assign this function to the three bottom switches of the GT1000 to operate with the looper. Now let's do it. Let's assign the pedal switches to the looper functions and to the effects. In the upper rows of switches I want to use the control one pedal to switch between the clean sound and the dirty sound, then the control two pedal to switch on and off delay, and the control tree for the chorus. As regard the lower row, I want to use the first switch for the univibe, the second for the compressor, and then the last three to control the looper. With the button number three, I will start recording or playing or overdubbing. With the fourth one, I will stop the looper, and with the fifth one, I will clear what I have just recorded. In order to do that, we need to press the menu button, then press the first knob here, the control assign button, and then once again for the control assign function. Here we have two matrix, the first one and this is the second one. One for the upper row of five pedal switches and the lower matrix for the lower row of pedal switches. So let's proceed assigning effects and looper functions to pedal switches. We said control one for selecting the effects way, I mean the clean channel or the dirty channel. So this is the div channel cell. Then with the control two, we want to switch on and off the master delay. With the control three, we want to switch on and off the chorus. Then we should go down to the second row of controls. With the control one, we want to control the univibe, that is FX1. With the second one, we want to control the compressor, here it is. Then the looper, record, play and overdub, and this is just called looper. With the second one, we want to stop the looper. With the fourth button, we want to stop the looper, here it is. And with the third one, we want to clear what we have recorded. And it's done. Let me tell you a few considerations about the looper of the GT1000. First of all, the recording time is limited to 19 seconds in stereo, and it is not too much if you think about it. Another thing that I don't like too much is that the looper starts recording exactly in the moment when you press the record switch without waiting for you start playing. Actually, I prefer loopers that are armed when you press the record button, start recording when you actually start playing. Another thing that I would like to have is the possibility to record more than one loop, having the possibility to browse them and recall them lately. That is actually not possible with the GT1000. So finally, the best use of the GT1000 looper is when you are doing a sound check in live situation, because you can loop a sound and go far away listening to the sound you have created and tweaking it with the tablet and with the GT1000 iOS app. So we reached the end of this video. Thank you very much for following me. Please subscribe to my channel and hit the notification button. It would be of a great help. See you in the next video.